Hey guys, I'm Leo Rank, the Guitar Maniac, and today I'm gonna show you my new custom guitar that was made specially for me by Plug-In Guitars. It has maple neck with rosewood fingerboard, ash body, and a couple of nice features as well. Well, of course, not all of the instruments made by Plug-In Guitars look like this. In most of the cases, they are actually ready to use. I just wanted to have my very own high-quality DIY kit to build my own guitar. Well, it might take a while until I put it together. In meantime, you can enjoy the background story and some footage of how this guitar was made. What did I know about electric guitars when I was a kid? Basically, those were the coolest instruments ever, and the guy who owned those was the luckiest bastard. In other words, I didn't know anything. Back then I had four favorite models. Gibson ES and Gibson Les Paul had kind of conservative design, and this was a basic idea of how classical music instruments should look like. Rickenbacker. Well, John Lennon played it. And of course, my number one choice was Fender Stratocaster. It had such a futuristic shape that one thing was clear. You're on a Strat, you're a cool. Of course, when I started playing guitar myself, I've got a different preferences. My first choice nowadays is Ibanez RG. And Gibson guitars are a good piece of history, but not the instrument that I would choose in the first place. As for the Stratocaster, I couldn't quite get over it. Its design was way ahead of its time. And this is nice concept of perfect ergonomics for achieving the best playing comfort. But I also wanted to have a Strat in my collection because of its unique glassy sound. And in fact, there are only two types of electric guitars for me. The first type are the guitars with unique Stratocaster glassy sound. And the second type are all the rest are electric guitars. But then again, there were a couple of things that I wanted to improve by original Strat. Some of those were personal preferences, like 24 frets or 2 tone controls that I never use, and some of those are just better technical solutions. For example, a lot of Strats still have this weird squared neck joint which doesn't allow the easy access of the last frets. Well, of course, this was improved by some of the models. And the second thing was a pickup mount. You see, I prefer the direct mount instead of the pick guard. No matter how good your guitar is, sometimes you need to fix a couple of things, like cleaning the contacts or change the potentiometer. To do this on the guitar with the pick guard, you have to remove the strings first, then you have to unscrew the pick guard, and then it hangs on the ground wire that you have to unsolder. And you can skip all those steps on the guitar with the direct mounted pickups. And so, ordering the custom Strat was a nice option for me. I decided to go with the classical Stratocaster wood types. For the neck, I chose maple. Well, you can't go wrong with this. And for the fingerboard, I chose rosewood, simply because I like the way it looks. And if you want to get Stratocaster sound, you can't go wrong with the bodies made of alder, ash or basswood. But ever since I've got the guitars with basswood and alder bodies, I decided to go with ash. And besides, ash has a nice wood structure that simply looks good. But ash is also pretty heavy wood, and so I decided to go with the chambered body to reduce the weight of the guitar. Well, of course, I don't have the luthier skills to turn a piece of wood into an instrument, and I'm glad that Adrian Plug-In made this part for me. But when the kit was ready, I started to assemble it myself. For some reason, I like either sunburst or red guitars, and so I decided to go with a wood dye. This way I could paint my guitar red and I could still see the wood structure. And I decided to paint neck red as well, just for fun. This isn't difficult part at all. You just use a piece of foam to cover your guitar evenly with a wood dye. Then you let sit it for a while until wood absorbs it and dries out. And then you can go to the next step. I decided to cover my guitar with a tank oil because it's the easiest way you can brew at home. Besides, your guitar gets this original wooden look, but is still protected from the humidity. The only problem with the tank oil is it takes a couple of weeks until it dries. And if you go with the multiple layers, which I did, it might take you several months until you can finally assemble your guitar. So, a couple of months later, I could finally do a next step. I decided to go with the Wilkinson VS100 vibrato. It stays in tune perfectly. You can do all kinds of crazy stuff with it, which you can do with the Floyd Rose, but changing the strings is much easier. And because I used non-locking vibrato, I decided to go with the locking tuners made by German brand Schaller. Of course, if you want to achieve a straight sound, you should go with the single coils, but I decided to go with the stacked hum-canceling pickups from DiMarzio. For the neck position, I chose Virtual Vintage 54 Pro. For the middle, Virtual Vintage Blues. As for the bridge, I decided to go with the Chopper, the single coil sized humbucker. First of all, it fits perfectly for a 3 single coil Stratocaster design. And secondly, I don't really need a single coil in a bridge position. Single coil in a bridge position has a lot of squeaky trebles. They might be good for some music genres, but in other ones you have to avoid them, especially when you kick it in an overdrive. And with the humbucker in a bridge position, I wanted to make it much more universal. First, I wanted to go with the one tone control instead of two like in an original Strat, but then I figured out that I actually have never used the tone control knob once in my life. And so I decided to go with only volume control knob. I really like how Edward did these wooden covers instead of plastic ones that I wanted to have in the first place. And so after several months of work, here comes a great moment of truth. And so here it is, my very own custom Strat. And what can I say about it? Well, first of all, when I put it together, I noticed that all the parts fit perfectly well together. There is no gap, for example, between the neck and the neck pocket, and there is nothing waving around. And actually, I have never seen such a precision work at any guitars. So, nice job. The neck is kind of based on Ibanez RG. It's pretty wide and pretty thin. This is the kind of what I like. If you take a look at the neck joint, well, it's very nice. You can really play up to the 24th fret without any issues. That's exactly what I wanted, but Edward took it to the next level. For example, he took away this sharp corner here, and so it actually feels smooth when you play up on here. I stole the idea of pickup placement at the Joe Satriani. When he designed his 24 fret guitar, he wanted his neck pickup be as close to the neck as possible. And that was what I was after. If you take a look here, the neck pickup is actually touching the neck. So if you take a classical Strat that has a kind of gap between the neck and the neck pickup and compare the pickup placement with my guitar, well, the pickups are actually almost at the same positions, so there is actually no issues with 24 frets and neck pickup. It sounds exactly the same as at the original Strat. Well, I guess it's time to just take a quick test and to listen to how it sounds. So here is a neck pickup. So, neck and middle pickup. Middle pickup on its own. Middle and bridge pickup. And bridge pickup. Well, a couple of things about the bridge pickup. This is a DiMarzio Chope. And actually, when I was kind of looking for the information about this pickup, I wanted to see a test videos in YouTube, and there were a couple of those, but with a Chope in the neck position. And I have never seen any single video with the Chope in a bridge position. And maybe this is the first one. I don't know. So, what can I say about it? The official homepage says that this is a kind of pickup that's in between the single coil and the humbucker. And at some point this is true. Because if you take a listen... less trebles than a single coil, but still more clarity than a humbucker. And you can't really say if this is sound of humbucking pickup or single coil, whether when it's in a clean settings. And another thing what I like when I can put the neck and middle pickups together, it sounds if there are two single coils. But when you kick it in an overdrive, with an overdriven sound as a regular humbucker. And That's why this guitar is kind of all around. You can play anything you want with it. Well, maybe not the Scandinavian black metal, but it works perfectly well from the blues, jazz up to the heavy metal. And I actually like the sound of the neck pickup with an overdriven settings. Ever since those are hum cancelling pickups, I have no issues with the pickup noise. And the best part about this guitar is, this wasn't much more expensive than a standard Strat. Well, of course I could save a little money because I assembled it myself, but actually if I wouldn't make it, so it wouldn't be much more expensive than a standard guitar. So, if you want to order the same kind of guitar, or maybe the guitar of your personal choice with your personal design, any weird ideas, so you may contact Eduard Plakan. I put the link below the video. And this is all for today, and have a nice day.